In a spaceship drifting through space, Monty is doing his best to raise baby Willow alone. He is the only member left of the crew, so he is in charge of taking care of everything, from Willow to the garden and even ship repairs. This proves to be very difficult sometimes, because Willow does not like being alone, even if Monty talks to her through a microphone. Hearing her cry makes him nervous, and sometimes it causes Monty to make mistakes, like dropping his tool in the middle of the fix. Monty tries his best to give Willow a good life, considering the circumstances. He plays with her, shows her movies so she can learn what the Earth was like, sings to her, falls asleep by her side, and showers her with affection. However, dealing with a kid also means Monty keeps having flashbacks to his own childhood, and the day he killed his best friend because she had killed his dog. Every evening, after Willow falls asleep, Monty sends his daily report to Earth, which is needed in order for the computer to know he is still alive and keeps the life support systems for 24 hours more. One day, noticing he needs to start saving on electric energy, Monty decides to jettison everything unnecessary. This, unfortunately, includes all the bodies of the crew that are still in the cryogenic units at the morgue. Monty at least wants them to have a little dignity though, so he puts them all in their astronaut suits before pushing them off the ship. Afterward, he is so overwhelmed by the meaning of his act that he falls to his knees to cry his heart out. Sometimes, while Willow is asleep, Monty confesses how hard this is for him and how easy it would be for him to lose it and kill them both. He tries to keep his sanity by raiding the medicine cabinet, but other things make it worse, like the images of Earth that he puts up for Willow that just reminds him of what they cannot have. Monty thinks these images were probably uploaded into the system and give the crew the illusion that return was possible. Taking Willow around the ship for games also means that Monty keeps remembering all the important moments he had with the crew in the different rooms and hallways, reflecting on how it all even started. A group of death row inmates is chosen to be sent on a mission in space to extract alternative energy from a black hole, but they are not told that they will never come back. Earth cannot even get their reports properly anymore because they take years to arrive. Among the inmates, Monty himself and Boise, a neurodivergent girl that Monty has to keep from hurting herself. After 3 years on the ship, Boise is angry because the crew has finally realized they are never coming back, and Dibs knew it yet kept it from them. Dibs is the ship's doctor, and she is the head of the experiment, which allows her to use the others as guinea pigs. Dibs's goal is to create a child in space through artificial insemination, but so far it has not worked. Boise tries to make Dibs understand that nothing grows inside them, but Dibs does not listen, especially when inmate Electra manages to get pregnant, although she is going through constant pain. Pilot Nansen expresses her worries too, because even if a baby does manage to be born, they will just die from radiation, but Dibs is nothing but persistent and keeps on collecting the male inmate seed. Intimacy among the inmates is forbidden, but the ship is equipped with the box, a room with a machine that helps the crew have fun on their own. Dibs likes using the box as well, but Monty, after a few uses of his own, chooses to stay celibate. He rejects all of Dibs's advances and complains about the sedative she keeps giving everyone before bedtime, but at least Dibs's fondness for him allows him to keep his fluids to himself. Monty's only real friend among the crew is Cherny, and together they like working in the ship's garden while discussing various philosophical topics. It helps Monty stay sane, unlike their captain Chandra, who is slowly being taken over by stress. Dibs discovered he has bad genes, and soon they turns out to translate into leukemia invading his body. When the ship reaches the halfway point, which equals only 4 more years for reaching its destination, the crew has to start the deceleration maneuver so the ship would approach the closest black hole in their galaxy. Extracting the energy from the black hole is supposed to provide humanity with almost boundless resources, but by now, the crew knows better than to still believing the speech about being heroes that they were given when it all began. As time passes, the lack of intimacy starts to get on some of the inmates' nerves. Itori keeps being a creep towards the girls and uses his hand while watching others. Chandra keeps making passes at Dibs, who plays with him before rejecting him. Since the boys use their hands so much while they are in their beds, a stink has begun to infest the room, and Cherny decides to start sleeping in the garden. Dibs keeps on inseminating the girls, but Boise refuses to be her experiment. So whenever it is her turn, after Dibs is done with her, Mink keeps an eye on the doctor while Boise uses a douche to avoid getting pregnant. Eventually, Electra gives birth, but just as Nansen had predicted, the baby soon dies of radiation, leaving Dibs crying in despair. Unfortunately, Electra dies as well. When Dibs takes her body to the morgue, Boise tries to put some herbs on Electra's body, following her religious beliefs, but Dibs yells at her and takes it back because it would clog the machine. Sometime later, while exercising, Chandra has a stroke. Dibs puts him in a bed in the infirmary, but there is an issue. As the captain, only Chandra's finger chip can activate the computer that sends the reports and keeps the life support system working. Fortunately, Dibs thinks fast, and using a scalpel, she changes her chip for his in order to do the reporting herself. Later, Dibs tries to comfort Chandra, but it is obvious he is quite gone and barely surviving, so Dibs decides to euthanize him. One night, Itori sneaks into the girls' room, and after binding Boise and Mink to their beds, he tries to take advantage of Boise. The girls wake up and begin screaming, so Itori breaks Minx's nose before covering Boise's mouth with his hand and getting back to business. The screaming they did is still enough for Nansen to come from the other room to try to pull Itori back, but Itori overpowers her and throws her in the hallway. After beating Nansen up, Itori tries with Boise again, but then Monty arrives and pushes him to the floor and starts hitting him. Journey arrives as well, and after stopping Monty from going too far, he frees the girls. While Monty takes Boise to the infirmary, Mink takes a chance to jump on Itori and kills him. In the infirmary, Dibs examines Boise and confirms Itori did not get to enter. After commentating she never wants to have kids, Boise takes the chance to ask Dibs if it's true that she was sent to jail because she killed her children and husband. Dibs confirms it is indeed true, and when Boise wonders why she did not end things for herself as well, Dibs explains she tried and failed. Since that disastrous night, Dibs begins doubling the dose of sedatives to make everyone sleep deeply for hours without a chance of waking up. The only one still awake is Nansen, because as the pilot, she cannot be sedated in case of emergency. One evening, Dibs gets tired of all the failed attempts in her experiment and decides to finally get the strongest genes on the ship. She sneaks into Monty's room and gets busy with him without him even knowing. Then, she takes a seed out of her body and puts it in the syringe to inseminate Boise while she sleeps. 9 months later, a beautiful baby is born, although Dibs does not tell anyone who the father is. The doctor dotes on the child constantly, keeping the baby with her in the lab all day long. This leaves Boise going through postpartum depression, covered in milk that she cannot feed to her own kid. When the ship finally approaches the black hole, Nansen gets ready to pilot a shuttle around it. Everyone gathers around the computer screen to watch her take off except for Boise, who is in the garden looking for a shovel. When the shuttle finally leaves the ship, something weird immediately happens. The shuttle dives into the black hole instead of flying around it. The crew then realizes it is not Nansen doing the piloting, it is Boise, who killed Nansen with the shovel and took the pilot's place. Boise ends up dying inside the black hole with an exploded head due to spaghettification. Mink is furious to see her last two friends gone and retrieves the shovel to attack Dibs, injuring her but not managing to kill her because Monty intervenes and kills Mink first. With no pilot to keep trajectory and no more women to inseminate, Dibs finally gives up. She takes out the chip from her finger and leaves it for Monty before telling him that the baby is his. Then she ejects herself into space. Shortly afterward, Journey remembers a quote from his wife that says, "I would rather sink into the earth after I have lost you than to sit around and grieve." Finally understanding the hardship of grief the quote refers to, Journey decides to follow the words and goes to bury himself alive in the garden. With everyone gone, Monty dares to take the baby out of the lab and names her Willow. Years pass, and Willow is now a teenager that can help Monty with the chores around the ship. Monty and she do not share a bed anymore, but they do sleep in the same room. One night, Monty realizes Willow has sneaked back into his bed because something's bothering her. It turns out she is having her first menstrual cycle. One day, they see something very shocking on the computer screens, another ship that looks just like theirs. While Monty's is number 7, this one has a 9 on it, meaning Earth is still sending these experiments into space. Nobody answers the messages they are trying to send to this other vessel, so Monty decides to connect both ships and board the number 9. What he finds there is quite disturbing. This ship had been filled with dogs who have also been giving birth to puppies. Most of them are dead now, and the few that are still alive have survived by feeding on the others. Willow asks Monty to bring a puppy back so they can keep it as a pet, but Monty refuses because the contamination could kill them both. This causes Willow to mention cruelty, but Monty reminds her she does not know what true cruelty is. Sometime later, Monty finds Willow praying. She does not know what god she is even praying to or what she should be saying, but she saw it on TV and wants to know what those people felt. Willow likes making awkward comments, like saying that Monty is not a criminal to her but a hero, and asking if she looks like her mother. To which Monty always answers no, before pointing out she is special and different. One day, the ship finds a new black hole. While Willow and Monty had come to terms with being drifters, Willow thinks the black hole looks incredibly interesting and wants to try to fly through it. Monty is skeptical at first, but ends up accepting, and the two of them put on astronaut suits before boarding the shuttle. Father and daughter hold hands as the shuttle enters the black hole, a bright yellow light enveloping them. Make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications so you can watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.